Today I'm going to be doing a watercolor demonstration. If you have any questions or want me to stop or want to throw things at me, go right ahead. All right. Now what I'm going to be painting today is this scene with the sailboats. And they're lightning class sailboats out of the port of Sheboygan. Here we go. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to just wet some of the paper with clear water. I think I'll use a smaller brush. And the key with watercolor painting is try to save your white paper. And my paints have already somewhat dried already in the palette.
Ooh. How much time have you got to well, they're still usable if you put them out in the palette?
Well, it depends. If you're outside on a warm day. Well, on here, I put these in the palette from a tube about an hour ago, and they're already starting to dry out. Which is not real good. So I'm using some cerulean and some violet. I'll let the paint run. Sometimes the key is to definitely mix enough paint so it's the same color all the way across. Oh, it's already a different color. You can see you have the basic shape already. Of the sails. And with watercolor, it's always tempting to go back over your strokes. And it's not always a good idea. And the other thing, not every painting works. Now with the sailboat, I want to leave the sails white as possible, and the different parts of the hulls of the sailboats. And at the same time, try to put some kind of soft horizon. Seems to work. Now the back sail is somewhat a little darker, so I'm going to try to make that happen. Going to try to give the hull some kind of shadow. I just try to paint fast and quickly, and now again, the key is trying to remember to leave some white paper. You have some splashes of water here and on this side. There's a term, hard and soft edges. You want to keep certain areas soft and certain areas hard. Such as the top of the boat, very crisp. Now when I do the water in this scene, I'm going to put several different layers of blue, because that's what I see.
Different blues?
Yeah.
Okay.
different blues.
Right. Aqua. Morning. I'm using this is a 2-inch brush. It's the, not the largest one I have, but. See if I get some kind of aqua color here. Just so I don't cover up the buoy markers, I'm going to put those in, or try to put that in right away. It's a little too green, but trying to put some short or small details in the boat just to help give me a better visual of what I'm doing. As soon as I added these darks in here, you could really see the shape of the hull. through. Try to put some of the mast in. All right, it's starting to come to life. All right. My mind is racing around trying to, if I'm painting outside, I'm always in a hurry to get finished because the watercolor paintings, they dry really quick, and so I'm always moving around real fast and trying to work the areas before they get too dry.
I think that answers my previous question.
And before I know it, I'm done and ready to go on to the next painting. I don't always put all the details in. There's numbers in here, but I'll leave them out. Some lines I'll put in. Now I'll go back to the water portion. Try to finish that. I'm using quite a bit of just what I have in the palette that's puddled up as far as all kinds of blues. Okay. Now, as far as what I see, it's starting to get to that point where it's getting overworked. But I like a few areas where the paint just runs. And
rough water.
Yes, that's what I'm trying to create, the rough water feeling. And now I'm going to attempt the part that I least like to do, is put people in. So as far as I'm concerned, they're just shapes of color. Let's see. Some blue. That's good. Trying to look at how the overall feel of the painting is, and it's in my mind, it's fairly close to being done. I may forget some things that I want to put in, but if I forget it, it's okay.
How many drawers did you have today?
What?
How many brushes did we need for this?
For this painting?
Yeah.
4 or 5.
Okay, let me see them.
So I use this, I think this might be 1/2 inch, 2 inch brush, 1 inch, and there's another brush I like to use with this edge on it. You can do some scraping. The paint's already dry on the paper already, for the most part. I'm using Winsor & Newton paints. They come right out of these large tubes. And many people, watercolor painters, they'll paint maybe from a hard tube or whatever tray, and then you add a lot of water and you keep trying to loosen up the paint. And that's not always a good thing to do, because it ends up being weak colors. And oil painters, they never, well, they could thin their paint a little bit, right?
Actually, I do a little bit.
Do you?
But you get a much more saturated color this way.
Yeah, and you have more of a flow with oil. Whereas watercolors, your flow is the water. That's what makes things flow.
I'm a little confused about your horizon line. I think it arrived late.
Here? Is it here or here? Is that what you're...
That's, yeah.
Well, it's a good question. I could make... I could try to soften it up. And with watercolor, you can lift some areas. I don't know if that helps. Actually, the horizon line was it was higher. I just tried to do something different there.
All right, so when I finish a painting, it really helps to put a mat on the painting, and it stands out quite a bit.